All right. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Mindgasms. So, I decided to start another video series that I'm going to do on Epictetus's book called The Art of Living, the classic manual on virtue, happiness, and effectiveness. Of course, by the famous Stoic author. I wanted to do this video series because I've recently reread that book and got into Stoicism I've been into it for years on and off and to varying degrees. But I got back into it recently because I've had some personal problems that I always have to deal with, but sometimes I have more trouble than at other times. And I've been having a lot of trouble with dealing with depression and anxiety and OCD a lot lately. So I wanted to get some help, and I know that Stoicism has helped me a lot before. And The Art of Living is my favorite book on Stoicism. I don't like Stoicism as much as I used to because I've learned about other philosophy that has made me place less value in things like reason and rationality, which are big, important values in Stoicism. But I still think that they have, all of the Stoic authors that I've read have some of the best practical life advice that is very helpful to many people, I would say. So I'm going to, each page of this book basically has like its own little maxims there, and it's really short. I highly recommend reading it if you want to. It's like this short. It's like just over 100 pages. And so anyway, I'm going to read the first maxim here and just sort of give my thoughts on it and elaborate a little bit about it, because this one in particular has helped me a lot too, and I know it's helped other people as well. Okay. Know what you can control and what you can't. Happiness and freedom begin with the clear understanding of one principle. Some things are within our control and some things are not. It is only after you have faced up to this fundamental rule and learned to distinguish between what you can and can't control that inner tranquility and outer effectiveness become possible. Within our control are our own opinions, aspirations, desires, and the things that repel us. These areas are quite rightly our concern because they are directly subject to our influence. We always have a choice about the contents and character of our inner lives. Outside our control, however, are such things as what kind of body we have, whether we're born into wealth or strike it rich, how we are regarded by others, and our status in society. We must remember that those things are externals and are therefore not our concern. Trying to control or to change what we can't only results in torment. Remember, the things within our power are naturally at our disposal, free from any restraint or hindrance. But those things outside our power are weak, dependent, or determined by the whims and actions of others. Remember, too, that if you think that you have free rein over things that are naturally beyond your control, or if you attempt to adopt the affairs of others as your own, your pursuits will be thwarted and you will become a frustrated, anxious, and fault-finding person. There you go. That's that maxim. Know what you can control and what you can't. I think this is a very important maxim that I have trouble remembering and need to remind myself of all the time, and I'm sure a lot of you do as well. And it's just, I get stressed out about these things that I can't control, like bad things that happened or things that I'm worrying about happening in the future. But all you can control is what you're doing at this present moment. All you can do is control how you react to events, how you react to what happens, and what you decide that you want to do with your day and how you want to interact with people. You have control over your life decisions. You don't have control over how other people behave towards you or, you know, bad things that happen to you. Every day I get, well, not every day, but most of the time I get pissed off by little stupid things that happen throughout the day, by like I spill a cup of coffee or some shit and I get pissed off about it, even though it doesn't really matter. And I can't do anything other than clean up the mess and control whether I get stressed out about that or not, right? So this kind of advice is really important for me, and I'm sure many other people to remember as well. And also, I just wanted to note, this is an essential principle of Stoicism. Know what you can control and what you can't. Focus on what you can control. Don't focus on what you cannot control, because that doesn't concern you and it doesn't matter anyway. And this principle in Stoicism, this was basically copied by Christianity, I would say. You know, the famous Serenity Prayer. It's not actually in the Bible, but I think it's commonly at least associated with Christianity. Whether that's historical or not, I'm not entirely sure, but I had heard that from somewhere before. But anyway, I forget which philosopher it is. It's one of those seminal Stoic philosophers like Seneca or maybe Marcus Aurelius. In some of their writing, one of their books, it has the Serenity Prayer almost verbatim, but it doesn't have that religious language. So the Serenity Prayer itself, as I remember, is, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. That's basically encompasses this lesson too. Know what you can control and what you can't. So like some things that you cannot change, that it talks about in this maxim, right? Like you can't control like the physical appearance that you were born with to an extent. Like you can work out, of course, and Stoics are definitely fans of improving your physical body and improving your mind, but you can't control, like, I can't control the fact that I'm white, for example, or the fact that I'm male, or the fact that I wasn't born into a rich family, or anything like that. And so the serenity, you have to have the serenity to accept those things, which takes a lot of work, and I'm working on that really hard, and I'm sure that's hard for everyone else too. And the courage to change the things I can. I'm a little better at that, but I procrastinate about some things like a lot of people do too. And there are some areas of life where I'm much more disciplined about those sort of things than I am at other things. And I want to improve on those. And then the wisdom to know the difference is, I think that's the hardest part of knowing the difference between what you can control and what you cannot control, or what you can change and what you can't. Because there are so many things like that you want to control, but you can't, right? Like you can't make someone like you, no matter how much you want them to like you. Maybe they're just not going to like you no matter how much you want them to. And it doesn't matter, because you can just accept the fact that you have other friends and they won't like you. Or if it's like a girl that you like, if you're a guy, or vice versa, if you're a girl, then maybe they won't like you and you'll have to go for someone else too. And, you know, like I can't go back in time and reverse the cup of coffee that I spilled, even though I really want to have superpowers and prevent that from happening. But you have to just understand that you can't change those things, and understand that I can't move things in my way, and no one gets their way 100% of the time. Every day something goes wrong, which is extremely difficult to accept, and you just can't control anything. Like, I'm not a control freak in any sense, but even people like me who are not that way at all, there are definitely things that we wish we could control, but we can't, because we don't have fucking supernatural powers, right? So we should all accept that. So I'll just go back to the maxim one more time. Know what you can control and what you can't. That is one chief maxim of the art of living. All right. So thanks to everyone for watching this first video on the first maxim that I'm going to do about the book, The Art of Living. Know what you can control and what you can't. And there are many, many more that I'm going to make. I'm going to make a short little video about each one of these maxims because I think they each deserve one. All right, so thanks everyone for watching. Thanks to those of you who press the like button on this video, those of you who subscribe to my channel, share the video everywhere, comment on it, and especially to those of you who give me money on Patreon. You have no idea how much I appreciate that. And like I always say, I love you all. Keep being the tiny beam of light that shines through the almost impenetrable darkness in the universe. And most importantly, always remember this: the funk cures all, and groove is in the heart. And know what you can control and what you can't. All right. Keep having mindgasms, everyone, and adios until next time.